Hello, everyone. Welcome to Cloth Tour Manufacturing. I am Craig Clotter. Today, we're going to do another free lesson with free software. You can download Student Edition Mastercam 2020. So what we're going to do today is the most versatile, universal program that you use in Mastercam on a daily basis for every user. So I'm going to do what is called a 2D toolpath today. And with the 2D toolpath, we're going to also cover ramp and chamfer and engrave, because those are the things I do with the 2D chant with 2D freaking toolpath contour. So let's get right into it, man. Boom. All right, here we are. I want to do a contour today, and then I'm going to do a ramp. So let's do a little bit of drafting. Okay, just bear with me. This way you can stay on the same page. It shouldn't be that hard for you. Click rectangle. Okay, we're just going to do a 2x2. So I just hit 2, tab, 2, and the width and height. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to click, oops, I'm going to come back, click anchor to center, man. We want that thing in the center. And then you want to go to your view, turn on show axes. And you're going to click that line there. Bam, now you got that. 2x2. Okay, we're going to do an outside profile today on that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to edge break it. And then I want to do a ramp. And the ramp I want to do at 625 thou diameter. Okay, then I'm gonna lock that so it stays at that diameter. I'm gonna bring it right over to the origin. It just locks right onto that, and then click. Just make one mouse, left mouse click, then green, check that, okay? So now you got this far, right? So now I want you to just left mouse click, highlight the whole damn thing. Transform, translate, go in your Z, go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So Z is -5. You want to join that. All right. Green check. Now, if you use your middle mouse wheel, you can scroll around. You can see that you just made this cube. Okay. So use your middle mouse wheel, scroll over. Let's say I have it like that. Okay. Right click, clear colors. Boom. Now let's surface this up. Why not? You know what I mean? Let's just for good freaking shit. So C-plane. And then we're going to grab C-plane. Then I'm going to grab these lines. See, I went all the way around the bottom perimeter. And I'm going to grab this line. It's going to go all the way around the top perimeter. Green check. Blue check. Then I'm going to hit C-plane. And then I'm going to do the same thing. See how the arrows are also, whoops, red that. See, I selected the wrong one. I selected the wrong one, so then I had to hit my unselect. And then I had to go back to the line I wanted and reselect it. Then I'm gonna green check that. And then I'm gonna green check that. Okay, so now we have our two surfaces. We just need to make two more, bear with me. We're gonna do a C-plane surface. Grab the two bottom lines, enter, enter. C-plane, grab the two top lines, enter, enter. Okay, green check that. Okay, there you go. So now what we want to do is we're going to go into our machine, mill, default. See how I did all that? Yay. So go right into here. Now we're going to go into our contour. Okay, we're going to start with our normal outside finish outside profile. Okay. So we're going to have today is you're going to go into your tool library. And you're gonna select your mill inch tool. Okay, go to your filter, turn all that off. Okay, if you know how to select your tool, that's great. Select end mill right here. Green check, go to half inch flat end mill. Double select that. Today we're working with aluminum, okay? So we're only going 500 thou deep, and the shoulder is 1.2. Okay, that's tool one. We have it in tool one. And we want to use this tool at 50 inches a minute and at 10 grand. Okay. Finish. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to type in finish outside. I already have that saved as my default. After you hit a certain parameter, you hit the save button, it'll save your default. So anyways, go right into 2D right here. 2D. All right. We're going to cut right stock to leave on walls. We're going to cut right at zero. We're going to do a finish pass on here because this block is really close to freaking done. So let's go right into here. Let's mind you, I'm using this contour as I normally do. Normally I do a dynamic, or some type of roughing technique, and then I come in with this contour. So that's why we're doing a finished pass. All right, let's say we got 5 thou to clean up. So we only need to really go 50-50 on that. Okay, I just put a 50 in here, 50 in here, and I selected that to transfer all these values to the lead in, lead out. Yay, multi-passes. So now we want one rough pass, and we don't want any spacing. Now we want two finished passes with zero spacing. Actually, no, we just want one. So it's going to go around the part twice. Now we're going to want to keep the tool down, and we're going to want to do it at all depths. Yeah, whatever. And then what on here, we're going to want to go minus 500 thou. That's what I said, okay? And we want all this in absolute. Your clearance wants, you want that to be on 1 inch. Absolute, absolute. Retract that to 100 thou. Feed plane, 100 thou. Top of stock is at zero. Depth, minus 500 damn thou. Arc filter tolerance, you're going to want to leave that alone because there's no coat at all to get rid of in this path. So now let's see what we have here. Our cutter's gonna go around. So what I did is I hit this blue squiggly line, and then I hit the blue play button. Now my cutter's gonna go around. Okay, looks good, looks good, looks good, looks good. Oh man, I don't want it to retract like that. It's gonna leave a gouge in my part. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna come into your parameters. You're going to your lead in, lead out. And then you're going to just simply select enter first depth of cut, exit on last depth of cut. Regenerate. Now, that'll take that away. Okay? So there you have it. Your outside contour. So now we got to do the center pocket here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to right click, drag this down, let it go, and I'm going to copy after. Now I'm going to go to my geometry. Go in here, right click on the chain, and then I'm going to delete the chain. Or sorry, I'm going to rechain all. C plane, and I'm going to grab that inside parameter. Make sure your cutter's on the left of that arrow, so it's going inside, okay? And then you're going to go to your parameter. We're going to use the same tool, all right? We want to slow it down on the ramp, though. It's going to heat up in there a bit. Okay, we're going to ramp the inside. Okay, but like I said, there's only five, but let's just say there's not. It's just a solid deal. You're going to go to ramp. So this is aluminum. I recommend 3 to 5 degree angle on there, okay? Lead in, lead out. It's a 625 degree diameter hole. It only has a 75 thou clearance aside. So if you give it a value greater than 75 thou, this path will alarm out and give you a cutter comp fail. A cutter comp cannot start on an arc. All right, did you get all that? Multi-passes. Okay, we want to do a finished number of pass at the final depth, okay? And then we're gonna do it, keep everything the same. So whatever the values are, we're gonna change. So let's regenerate that. So this is what we're gonna get. See, that's for a giant cutter like this, we're not really removing much steel in there, okay? I mean, this is just now I'm going off on just looking, feeling, and judgment. So I'm going to tell you that this ramp angle is going to have to be at 5. Okay? And then, right, we don't want linearized helixes on. If you have that on, that'll generate a shitload of code. We want to do arc movements. What the hell is that? All right? After you do that, hit save the defaults, okay? Yep. Because you do not want this linearized helixes on. So you don't want that on, bro. So, let's see what we got here after we rejuvenate that. I'm going to regenerate. Now it looks much better. You look in there, you can see the lead in, lead outs. Okay, that's what you want to be able to see. Then you know you ain't going to get no alarms. All right, now I'm going to look at my cutter cut. One thing I noticed, I did not assign my tool a holder. So I'm going to go into holder. And I'm going to want to give it a half inch side lock. Boom. Okay, we're going to snug that up right to 1.3. Okay, now I overrode my, no, I did not, sorry. Okay, so now we have outside finish pass, inside finish pass. Let's take a look at how she's gonna do it. Okay, I'm gonna come in here. I'm gonna hit Alt S, and that's gonna give me my wireframe view. Okay, we can see my cutter here. Looks pretty damn good. hit all this again. So now for the meat and potatoes, folks, the last thing I do with my contour, I mean, you can do it. I do so much with the contour. It's your only, the contour is as good as a user, and it's never ending, man. It's like the guitar or an instrument. You know what I mean? It really, truly is. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to get a chamfer mill or we want an edge break. So I go to contour. I'm going to hit C-plane, and I'm going to grab the outside perimeter. Okay, I'm going to green check. Go to my tool, and I'm just going to simply grab a normal spot drill, but it's going to be a chamfer, a carbide chamfer mill. I'm going to use a 1/8. Okay. I'm going to call this tool 2. I'm going to go back to the defined tool geometry. Okay, the cutting length is 0.5. Shoulder length is 0.5. Overall is 2 inches. Finalized property, tool 2, we're going to run this sucker. It's an edge break at 30-30-30 and at 10 grand, which is max spindle for this machine. Finish. And our man readable, we want to put edge break. 2/10 thou. Okay. We got that selected, that selected. We're going to come in here, do a 2D chamfer. Okay. For this particular value, you're going to want to put 0.02 and 0.02, and that'll get you where you need to be at. So here's your lead in, lead out. Turn your multi-passes on, lead in, lead out. You want to make sure you're larger than the chamfer size. So we got a 20 thou chamfer. We want to make sure we're larger than 20 thou here and larger than 20 thou there. And then hit your value over after you set that. And you want to keep this all at 0, 0, plus 1, plus 100 thou, and 1 inch. We should see a beautiful chamfer program. You come in here and hit play. Slow your tool down. See, you can see it breaking the edge. See that? Pretty cool, huh? There you go, man. And like I said, it's a very versatile, very universal program, technique, the 2D tool, contour toolpath, and it is only as good as the user, so. Anyways, I hope you like my tutorial. Take it easy, folks. Once again, you can download the free software at Mastercam.com, and you can get the student edition and go right with me step by step to learn Mastercam. Thanks again, Clouder Manufacturing. Peace out.